trailer, and we're going to jump on another trailer, and then we're going to wrap up. Oh, let's see. I don't know what this is about, man. This movie with Tom Holland and I think Robert Pattinson in there too, right?
Yes.
Well, The Devil All the Time. I have no idea Sebastian what this is about. Stan. Oh, it's a Netflix.
I think Sebastian Stan is. Yeah, I think this Sebastian Stan is in this too.
What is this, like a thriller?
I think so. Better like a revenge flick or something.
Okay, so let's watch this trailer, and then I have a little reaction and my thoughts on it, because I don't know what the, I don't know what this is at all, but I just know the actors that are in it. It's a Netflix, so that's something. So you got the trailer up?
Yeah.
Okay. The Devil All the Time, I'm playing now.
Happy birthday, Arvin.
Happy birthday, honey.
Happy birthday to you.
Damn, is that cornbread?
This was your daddy's.
I guess they
brought back from the war. I figure it's time to pass it on.
It's the best present I ever got. Thank you.
How and why people from two points on a map without even a straight line between them can be connected is at the heart of our story in Knock 'em Stiff.
You ever think about living in the same house?
I know what my daddy did.
Some people would say it's just dumb luck.
You take pictures?
I do. I see a smile pretty enough to photograph, that is.
Others would tell you it was God's plan.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness.
That ain't no preacher. He's as bad as they got on a damn radio.
When people look back on it, they had no other choice.
There's a lot of no good sons of bitches out there.
Excuse me, preacher.
You got time for a sinner.
You know, I studied something. It's called the delusion. A belief that is untrue. It is our delusion that lead us to sin. Delusions!
Some people were born just so they could be buried.
What I'm about to do, I do because I have to. Not because I want to.
September 16th, okay. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Huh.
That was The Devil All the Time. That's like a drama, thriller. Looked like a lot of...
Yeah.
I mean, look like it looked like it's a, I guess, a thriller. Yeah, thriller, drama. I mean, that's the best I can describe that. I mean, look interesting, too. I'm like, these... And especially being in Netflix, these Netflix movies are where these actors can like stretch their legs. They can do these experiment. They can experiment on their acting, you know, their range. Because I'm looking like they got all these British actors and they all trying to sound Southern and shit. They love doing that. Yeah. Like they love doing those Southern accents. What you think? Robert Pattinson actually didn't sound too bad. I thought, you know. When I just heard them in the trailer, what you think of how they sounded?
It's all right. You know, I will say, I feel like what's up on that? Tom Holland, he might be overselling it a little bit, you know, because he come off a little stiff with it. Robert Pattinson feels like he's comfortable doing it. Yeah.
It's kind of weird, yeah, though, seeing him doing that, though.
Yeah.
You know, it might be like a period piece, too. Looks like it takes place in, like, the 50s or something. Like, you could tell it's back. At least it's got to look like from the cars or whatever. It looked like it's 40s or 50s, you know, somewhere in the South. I didn't see no black people in there, so I guess it ain't going to be about no racial stuff. So relax, everybody.
Yeah. This is basically going to be a, what they used to call them, a moral play type thing.
Yeah, yeah. That's why I said a lot of these big name actors can kind of, and these are a lot of big blockbuster actors. So now it's like, okay, they can take these smaller films where they can kind of get more range out of their acting ability, yeah, you know? And it's cool. I'm looking like with all these names in there, why are you focusing on Tom Holland? But I mean, I guess we'll see.
I mean, I think like they trying to make him into more of a household name. Cause I know, I don't know if they still making it, but like they were adapting, the Uncharted series into a movie, and they were supposed to have Nathan Drake.
I know, which is very disappointing for me, because he did not fit that character at all. And it ain't even about, you know, looking like the character. You just got to have something that reminds you of that character, and he doesn't at all. I ain't going to say I'm not a fan of Tom Holland, but I'm not crazy about him, me personally. And I think he's okay. He don't blow me away like they trying to pump him out there. It's like they trying to put him out there like this dude is amazing, you know, like I don't see it, you know, he cool, but I don't see it, you know, like that. So,
well, like also if you're trying to focus on a younger actor, Bill Skarsgård is without a doubt a better actor than Tom.
Yeah, I know, but maybe because the character in the movie is probably based on a book, and the character is supposed to be a young guy, and that's your main, you know, that's your avatar throughout the whole thing, you know. So yeah, he got the young look, you know, maybe that's what they using or whatever. So
it is based off of a book, so.
Yeah, I'm figuring, you know, most of these are.
I'm still trying to wrap my head around the fact that there's actually a place called Knock 'em Stiff.
It's, that's the name they say.
It's Knock 'em Stiff, Ohio. This is a real place.
Okay. So anyway, it's going to be about like some family drama. Look like maybe some like serial killer stuff, or, you know, it's probably going to be some old, you know, backwater families. Somebody turned up dead. We think it might be this guy, might be that guy, you know, whatever.
It looks good, man.
They made a lot of these like in the 90s, a lot of these little thriller, you know, film noir kind of, you know, movies, where, you know, it's kind of a mystery too. A lot of these be a mystery. Who did it? You know, what's the, you know, and you'll find out at the end who did what and all this. Everybody look guilty, and then you'll really find out who's really the killer, you know, at the end, you know. So those interesting. I ain't had one of those in a long time. Cause you know, like I said, they was popular in the '90s, but they kind of fell out. So we'll see. And they got a lot of big name actors. So we'll see.
I will say this much: I know a bunch of people that ain't gonna be able to watch that scene when dudes dumps those spiders all over his face.
Who is that? You?
nah, not me. I wasn't expecting that, but you know, I know a bunch of folks that can't mess with spiders.
What you think the context of that was? It's like, was it because he a preacher? And he's trying to prove, you know, that he's immortal or some shit.
Well, no, you know what? I think it was like some snake oil faith healer stuff.
Probably. Right. Well, you see a lot of that. They used to do a lot of those televangelists used to do a lot of showy stuff that made it look like they was performing miracles and stuff. So that, you know.
And because because I'm strong in my love of the Lord, these spiders will not bite me.
Right. They probably like some non-poisonous spiders or something. And, you know, but I still wouldn't take a chance. Ain't no way I'm gonna do that.
Yeah, you missed me with that.
Yeah. So anyway, The Devil All the Time, man, based off a book. Could be good, man. We'll check it out. So And yeah, you'll get a review once it's out. You said it's in September?
September 16th.
So it's coming out in about a month. So yeah, you'll get a review from us once it's up. So, all right. Thanks for checking out the podcast. Thanks for checking out the stream. Go ahead, wrap it up. Please subscribe to the channel. And when you subscribe, hit the bell icon so you'll get alerts whenever we post another video. So I guess
whenever y'all see our videos, you know, thumbs up, comment, you know, help us beat the algorithm. We appreciate your help. And tell somebody to tell somebody about the Epic Entertainment Critics.
Yeah. All right, y'all. We out of here.